Welcome to Contact. We're glad you're joining us today for the fourth message in our series called Prepare a Place. Now today we're discussing, this is so important, how the power and presence of God in our lives is meant to break every chain of bondage that we encounter. We're not meant to live our lives in bondage, and God has made a way for us to be set free. Wow, right. So glad about
that. So we're using as an example the nation of Israel that were actually in physical bondage and they were locked in, but God got them free. And it's really quite a story.
That's right.
You know, but everything, I mean, they just got up and walked out.
And so, you know, it isn't just a Bible story that happened a long time ago. No. I always like to point out the fact that the Word of God is alive and filled with power. It's current. It never gets outdated. So that means that anything that you've been dealing with throughout this really trying period, challenging period that we've been in, you're going to hear about what God has done for you in this message today.
Right.
So stick
right.
with us.
Yeah, we're focusing on the answer, not the problem.
Right. So listen up.
Yet affordable Bible school education, then Faith Landmarks Bible Institute is for you. FLBI provides students with 2 years of comprehensive study. With our online program, you can learn anytime, anywhere. Register for our online Bible school today by visiting our website at flbi.org. Make the spiritual investment to grow in your knowledge of the kingdom here at Faith Landmarks Bible Institute. Do you have an artistic pursuit that you've been hesitant to start? Maybe you've started, but you want to advance further. If that's you, then Faith Landmarks Academy of the Arts is where you want to be. With beginner and advanced classes, you can take the next step into your artistic endeavor no matter where you're starting out from. View any of our available classes online by going to faithlandmarks.org and clicking on the FLAA tab. We are always adding new classes, so make sure to check back and find the class that's right for you. For more information, call our church office at 804-262-7104. We can't wait to see you grow in the talent God has given you. Sign up and join FLAA today.
Glory to God. God is good. And we want to again welcome everyone that joins us online. We thank God for you. And we know that a large portion of you are right here in the United States, even here locally. Praise the Lord. But then also this same service goes to various parts of the world. It goes all over the world and is being received in many numerous different places. And so we welcome you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. God is good. Okay. So look here, if you would please, in the book of Colossians chapter 1. Okay. If you're a brand new believer, it's in the New Testament, which is the back of the book. It's right after Philippians and it's right before 1 Thessalonians. And if that doesn't work, then you have a table of contents. Excuse me. My Bible, I'm reading to you out of page 1816. Okay, so I know that's not going to help you much because they don't even make these anymore. You know, I got the last batch. Hallelujah. Went before they stopped making the, you know, big cumbersome Bibles like that, leather bound. Woo, thank you, Lord Jesus. God blessed. All right, let's read this verse to you. Colossians chapter 1, verse 13. talking about Jesus, who hath delivered us, notice that's past tense, has delivered us, is already done, from the power of darkness and hath translated us into the kingdom of his dear son. Now, we're going to get a little thing started here. If you are, you say you're saved and you know you're saved, go ahead and go like that. Okay, now, if, for the record, if you don't know, by the end of the service, you can be a member of the body of Christ. We're going to lead you in a simple prayer. Let's do that again. If you're saved, raise your hand like that. Okay, so what actually happened, the work was already finished. And when you believed in what Jesus did for you at Calvary, I call it cashing in. You cashed in on everything that he did for you. It all belongs to you. Okay, it's now called your inheritance, at least in part. Okay, and it's everything that Jesus died to give you. It belongs to every single believer. There is nobody held back. There's not special groups and lesser groups or none of that. None of that is in the kingdom. Woo, God is good. So, you know, the whole idea of parity and liberty came from the Lord Jesus Christ. It's God's idea. That we would be born of the same spirit. Now, the outer man varies, okay, but that's not where our similitude is, except for the fact that the outer man is all of Adam. I haven't met an alien yet, which means every person on this planet is born of Adam to begin with. Okay, but then Jesus talked about a second birth. He called it the new birth. Amen. Born from above is other ways of translating it. Hallelujah. So any person and every person, it makes no difference who you are, where you came from, or what you've done. None of that has any effect. Zero. None. On the sacrifice that he paid for you at Calvary. It's already done and finished. It's just a simple matter of accepting and receiving what he did for you. Now, the book of Acts actually shows this. Sometimes people get saved without having a full knowledge of everything that belongs to them. So God wants to make sure that you're aware of your full inheritance, all of it that belongs to you. Okay, so that's why we're talking about deliverance right now. You're already delivered. It already belongs to you, but you might not be living in everything that belongs to you. So we've got some change to illustrate, which I'm going to make a little demonstration here about that momentarily. Get things organized here. I'm a very organized kind of a person. Hallelujah. God is good. But notice this verse. There's actually two sides to this verse. He says, delivered us out of the power of darkness. Now, before I got saved, I didn't know that there was a power of darkness. I thought everything was the same. You know, and everybody had the same experience. I didn't know there was two sides to everything. Okay? But it's right here in this verse, delivered us out of the power of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of his dear son. Now, when I got saved, I found out, first of all, I was able to see there's more to it than what I've been led to believe. But then I began finding out, okay, I am now in the kingdom. I'm kind of switching sides here for illustration purposes. And as I began personally to get a download from the Word of God, which never changes, unaltered by the hand of man, thank God for that, I began to find out what the Word says about what Jesus did for me. And it came into my life and I said, you know, I want that. I want to get a hold of that. Now, all of my life I had been bound by a group of maladies, physical illnesses that just kind of followed me around everywhere I went. And I went through this annual cycle of physical attack, weakness. Now, I was a healthy guy, you know, I was an athlete, but it didn't make any difference. I still, you know, had these things that would come on me. But then when I found out, okay, first of all, I got healed from a terminal disease. Okay, the day I got saved, that was simply by the grace of God. Okay, and completely delivered. But then I found out, okay, I don't have to go through this annual cycle anymore. That's the way I looked at it, because it was very debilitating. So after I got saved, after I was healed of the terminal condition, then I found out how to use my faith on the reoccurring issues. Okay, so I'm a recipient of this very thing that we're talking about. Let me tell you about another one. That is what I just explained to you. The power of sickness and disease is in the power of darkness. Satan uses man's weakness against himself. And people in the world, do they know that? They don't have a clue. Their minds are blinded. They have no understanding. Doesn't mean it doesn't exist. It's just that it's not apparent to them. Hallelujah. But there's this other one. Every single person on earth is born into this system that operates in the world. Every single person is born into what is called a station of life. Now, of course, not everybody is aware of it. Okay, but we could go in big, long explanation, but I'll just cut it short by saying that when people, whatever position people think that they're born into, when they try to get out of it, they run into this other layer of obstruction. And they can't get out of it. You know, claim that they rise up and come out of it for a while, but then, you know, in the end result, often what you see is it was a hollow experience. For instance, you know, people like in our culture think, oh, if I could just win the lottery. Talk to the people that won the lottery, and what you find out is the money didn't cure the problem. They blew through the money, and they still have the same problem. Woo, God. So there's these other bondages that Satan uses to hold people in captivity. And that's the reason why we have these chains up here today. We're going to take you through a cycle of deliverances that belong to you, that have actually already happened. When Jesus did it for you at Calvary, you just simply, like when you got saved, he didn't go back to the cross again for you to get saved. This works exactly the same way. All of these freedoms are already in Calvary. All you have to do is believe what he did, and the same way you got saved, you accept it. And we're going to show you this is going to happen to somebody. Hallelujah, but you accept it and then you're able to walk out free. Woo, hallelujah. So people spend their entire lives trying to get free from these things and don't realize that they personally don't possess the power. So let me read this statement to you. We personally do not possess the kind of power necessary to deliver us from the chains that bind us. Now, before I got saved, I came in contact with this because I was trying to get free from certain bondages, okay, and I'm sure you were too, and I found out, no, you know, I can't get free. There's some sweet Christian people came to me and told me, they said, well, you know, you can try to get free if you want to, but you're not going to get free. It was actually good news, even though it sounded like bad news. It was good news, and then they said, the reason is the devil is bigger than you, and he's the one who's holding you down. Okay, this was Christians telling me. They said, but never fear. Jesus is bigger than the devil. Now, you know, I mean, to me, that made sense. You know, Jesus is the big guy. And then they said, he will set you free. Hallelujah. So I took it all in, glory to God, and you know, I was ornery. And so I tried to do it on my own for a while longer, and I got worse. And then finally, this is part of my testimony, finally, when I was standing on death's door, now the terminal disease had progressed to the point where that, you know, I had about 15 minutes a day where that I could actually do anything. You know, the rest of the, 22 years old, bedfast, basically, except for a few minutes a day. Hallelujah. And so I was right on the edge. And so I knew that I was dying. Okay, you didn't have to explain it to me. I mean, all I had to do was look in the mirror. I was orange, had black spots. And my liver was sticking out from under. I was right on liver failure. My liver was sticking out from under my rib cage about 3 inches. This is very unusual for a 22-year-old athlete. Hallelujah. So I knew I was in trouble. So I knew I was going to die. But I also knew that I was going to go to hell. Nobody had to explain it to me. I could smell the smoke. Now, I do that in a funny way, but it's actually literal. You know, hell has a smell. Woo! And I didn't want to go to hell, you know. And so people had quoted a few of the statements that Jesus made to me. And then on the day when it was right, you know, it was the final day. Hallelujah. Jesus appeared to me and said, come unto me and you'll have everlasting life. So I did. I came to him. And, you know, all this time, see, I'm telling you this by contrast. All this time, I never knew that there were two sides to things. But suddenly, it was very graphic. There was the devil and the demons. And I mean, the demons came after me. You know, but Jesus just, woo! Faster than an atomic second, broke the whole thing over me, boom, and I was free. Woo, God is good. Go ahead and say amen. All right, now, if you would please go with me over to the book of Exodus. We're going to walk through this a little bit. We have a demonstration here that I'm going to do. I'm not going to actually break those chains until it's time. But I am going to break those chains. Woo, it's not because of my strength. I've learned how to do things in His strength. All right, so Exodus chapter 3. God is talking to Moses about what was going to happen with the nation of Israel. And though people in our culture discount and discredit this, I want to ask you just to listen for a minute. Because every single person on this planet is born into a financial station. And the world system is built on this tier thing, okay? And whether you're at the top of the world system or on the bottom, you're still in bondage. That's the thing that people find out. Money doesn't fix it, okay? But if you remember the nation of Israel, God started the conversation with Moses and then with Pharaoh that I want my people free. So they were to go out in the wilderness and have a worship service. Okay. Now that involved, first of all, they had to be able to get out, but they also had to have something to worship with. So here's God's remedy. Are you there? All right. Exodus chapter 3, verse 21, it says, and I will give this people favor in the sight of the Egyptians. And it shall come to pass that when you go, you shall not be empty. When he's prophesying, when God is saying, when I lead you out, you're not going to walk out empty-handed. Now, there's a lot of layers to this, but it should be understood that no person breaks these bonds without the power of God. And so right here, God is talking about something that is not apparent to man. He's calling it favor. Okay? And so favor with Pharaoh, are you kidding me? You know, I am an underling, so to speak. You know, listen to the world talk today about these things. Okay, so maybe some of my terminology is a little outdated. Okay, underling. Hallelujah. But there's an entire culture of people that are at the bottom of everything. And they're held down by the tier system on top of them. Which when you hear man talking, that's what he talks about, is how he wants to get free so he can run his own life. Who are you there? And so this pressure cooker, you could call it, is pushing down. It's called oppression. It's pushing down on every person that is under the power thereof. So remember, it says he delivered you out of the power of darkness and translated you into the kingdom of his dear son. All right. So the power of darkness, I never even knew it was there, but it holds the entire world captive, and it should not be holding believers captive any longer. It's time for God's people, the body of Christ, to get up and walk out. Welcome back. Really glad that you're with us today on Contact. Wow, this is powerful. It's big, and it keeps getting bigger the more we talk about it. So the power necessary to deliver a person from bondage, human beings just generally don't have that kind of power.
Right.
Okay. But God is the one who has the power, and so he's the one who delivers us and breaks every chain.
That's right. A power greater than ourselves. So many people are self-reliant. Oh, I can do it. I've got this.
Yeah.
You know, and then three or four years later.
They run up against things that they've never dealt with before in life, and they're completely baffled.
Right. And so it's an important thing to learn that God wants us to rely on him.
And turn to him.
And turn to him because he's there. He called it the throne of grace to get help and mercy in a time of need.
Yeah.
So, you know, if you've got needs in your life, he's sitting on this throne of grace and he's just waiting to help you through these trials.
And he is prone to answer your prayer.
Yeah.
You know.
Amen. All the promises of God are yes and amen.
In Christ Jesus.
In Christ Jesus. Yeah. Yes. So, and all these things, you know, are taught in depth at our Bible school. And our Bible school year here is underway. But the classes are not just for those who live in or near our Richmond area. We've built a new online platform for our school and a new way to spread the gospel around the world. If you've wanted to attend Bible school to learn more about God and His Word and His will for your life, but there isn't a Bible school where you live, or your work schedule won't allow you to attend in person, you can join FLBI online and work on courses at your own pace. Now, registration for FLBI online carries on throughout the year. It's all year round. Visit FLBI.org or contact the school office at info@FLBI.org for more information. FLBI is also a means that we use to train disciples of Christ and church leaders all over the world. During this recent pandemic, our Bible schools in America and other nations were able to continue operating, and we recently graduated hundreds of students to carry the gospel into the cities, villages, workplaces, wherever they were able to do that. And portions of your contact giving helped provide FLBI materials to students around the globe free of charge. and it's helping to fulfill the Great Commission in the earth.
Yeah, and like we've said before, that was really a surprise to us. When we built FLBI, it was not intentionally made to be an outreach arm or a tool of evangelism, but it has turned into that because every one of the students then becomes a witness for Christ, and they're going into all the world and preaching the gospel, just exactly like what Jesus said. Now, so you can find out everything that you need to know about this ministry by visiting our website, contact.tv. Information on how to give into the ministry is also at the bottom of your screen. So here's another look at some of the things that we're doing and what's coming up.
For over 30 years, Faith Landmarks Bible Institute has expanded its accessibility to people around the world. FLBI continues to grow and reach new regions through newly acquired equipment and technology, and through faithful partners overseas. On May 20th, 2021, over 70 FLBI students in Kenya graduated from first and second year. Thanks to your financial seed, Faith Landmarks Ministries through FLBI was able to equip them with the wisdom and knowledge of God's Word so that they can accurately proclaim the truth of the gospel to everyone they meet. Sowing into missions equips FLM with the ability to broaden our outreach, increase our online capabilities, expand our Bible school, and fulfill the Great Commission. Visit faithlandmarks.org or text FLMVA to 73256 to sow into missions today.
That you've been with us today. Hope it's been a blessing to you. Also, we'd like to extend a personal invitation to you that you might come to Faith Landmarks Ministries, our location here in Richmond, Virginia. Now, if you don't know how to get here, what you can do is, and if you'd like to come, you can look on our website, faithlandmarks.org. Not only can you get directions, but you can find out about all the schedule of activities, times of the services, how to navigate the facility. All those kind of things are right there on the website. And so you're welcome. We'd love to have you. We love you and appreciate you. And we look forward to seeing you back again on Contact.